Good morning, everybody. I'm Will Taylor. I'm glad you've tuned in today to my live podcast. And if you're here for the first time, you're wondering what this is about. This is a space where I share thoughts, feelings, ideas that I feel may benefit some of you. By sharing through this platform, we can all be closer together and help each other on the journey of life. It's a place for me to be vulnerable, and I bring up ideas and concepts that I'm working on with the hope that you may contribute in comments below with your own life, and that, again, we can be more together and in community through this technology. So really, I bring them to the forefront here. It's kind of like my digital journal, because I don't think there's really anything to hide. I think that we can use this technology for good. So I really want to hear your comments below. I want to hear where you're watching this from. One word, how you feel today. And I want you to know that I'm planning on building this into a podcast, and I'm still looking for a title. Things I've been saying, or I've been thinking about calling it, are Will's Wide World or Will's World of Adventure, because I want it to encapsulate, I want it to hold, to be a container for all of the things that are happening in my life that I can share with you, again, so that we can have a broader conversation. Of course, it is my love to bring music and community and togetherness and to as many people as I can, because I think we can have less suffering and we can have more joy when we're in this together. Hi, Cindy. So the topic of my talk today is everything you love will be taken away. And I think that's a song title by Slade Cleaves, who's one of the artists that I worked with early on in the early Strings Attached days, when we worked with singer-songwriters like Eliza Gilkison, Slade Cleaves, Ray Wiley, Hubbard, Chip Taylor, who wrote the song Wild Thing, and Angel of the Morning. A lot of these artists we work with. I am working on getting a website together where you can see all that history of the different artists that we've worked with. So everything that you love will be taken away. That came up because here's what I was thinking about. I'm talking to my daughter who's having a really hard time in life right now. And what I wish for her, what I wish for any young person, is to have a love so strong, a curiosity, a joy about a topic in life that it sets a flame aside in yourself, in your heart. And it's something that you can hold for yourself no matter what is happening in life. So for me, that's been music, a love of the arts, a love of music, a love of creativity. And no matter what is happening in my life, I can always turn toward music. I can turn toward, I don't need anybody else. It's something, it's a little flame that burns inside me that can distract me, that can provide me a distraction from the disappointments, the scariness, the anxiety in life. It's a little bit of a compass that I can go to. And I know lots of you, that could be Dungeons and Dragons, that could be reading, that could be acting, that could be any kind of activity where you lose yourself in that activity, where you become in the flow, where time slows down. And that when you find that early in life, that is a little compass that you can carry with you throughout life. And so it's really hard for me to see my daughter struggling so hard. And I was thinking about that, and I was thinking like, well, I was challenging myself on that idea. For me, music is something I can go to alone, by myself. I can pick up my guitar. At any moment, I could pick up a score or a piece of music. I could hum a song. Let's say I don't have access to listening to music. I could go within, and I could be working on a melody, and that takes me away to a place where I feel at home and at peace, into a flow. So the question I asked this morning was, Well, could that be taken away from me? And yes, it could be. How could that be taken away from me? I could lose the ability to use my hands. But I would still have that burning desire to share the love of music with another, with myself. I could still hear melodies. I could listen to music. I could talk about music. So what I'm trying to teach my daughter and other people, other children, not teach, but just share, let's say share, is that there are some things that are more difficult to take away from you in life. And I know Susan's watching, and I know that she'd have a lot to say on this with her experience. They can take away your senses, your hands, your ability to move, and eventually everything will be taken away from you that you love, including those that you love, because we will pass from this world into another world. So yes, it's true. But there are some things in life, some interests, some loves that are deep in your heart that are way more difficult to take away from you. Like they say, they can't take that away from me. There's a song about that, right? And I think that this love, this curiosity, this inner flame is really hard to take away. It's really, really, it's one of the things that can persist throughout your entire life. So without getting too like pedantical about it, what I'm getting at here is, as I wish my daughter had something like that, you know, instead of depending on feedback from others and a job or things that are more ephemeral that can disappear more easily. It's having that flame of curiosity. And so if I were to expand further on that, what I notice about music for me, it's not just the activity of discovering and exploring music by myself, but what I find is that shared love opens up this whole world of friendships, whole world of people that also love that. So once I have that skill of what's really about is about making friends and having a community around that skill, that love. It's like they say again, you can feed a man for a day with a fish, but if you teach him how to fish, then he can feed himself for a lifetime. That quote applies here. If you have a burning flame inside, if you know how to share that flame and make friends with others, then you're always going to have community and you're never going to be alone. So it's like having that confidence is one of the most calming sort of realizations to have about yourself. So I know that if, let's say, I'm never really going to be alone because I have this love of nature, I have this love of music, I have this love of connecting with others. As long as I can make friends, I can lose friends and I can make new friends. Lose friends, make new friends. Then there's that feeling of abundance. There's that feeling that I'm never really fully alone because I have the ability to go out and fish and find new friends. And that I'm always going to, no matter where I am, I'm going to be able to do that. And there's a peace and there's a serenity in knowing and feeling that. And I just really wish and hope that my daughter can learn that sooner than later. And I keep telling her stories and stories over and over again. But it can start with yourself and just having a curiosity and love that is so powerful that you enjoy it yourself so much that then you get to carry that and share that with others and make friends. It just seems like one of the simple rules of life, the simple secrets to life, I'll say. And you can carry that little kernel of knowledge around in you, and it gives you a certain amount of peace. Because there are so many humans out there. There are no lack of humans in the world that we live right now. So there's no lack for opportunities and potential to connect. And we all, no matter what situation you're in, whether we're in a marriage or not in a relationship, there's always the potential and opportunity to connect and make friends with others and therefore not be alone. That's what I wanted to share with you today. And if you want to if make a comment below, that would really mean a lot to me. click on the bell, be notified when I go live again. I am going to be developing these short talks into a podcast, Will's World of Adventure, Will's World, something like that. If you have an idea for a name, put it down below. If you want to make a contribution that is tax deductible to the work I do, there's a link in this video. Austin Creative Alliance is our nonprofit sponsor. $1 to $1 million tax deductible. You can check out the work that I do at a website I've set up called willhelps.com. It's been in existence for over 13 years. You can see all the community work that I do. willhelps.com. Reaching out to the elderly, reaching out to children and showing them music. You can see the work that I do giving free nature walks with music almost weekly here in Austin, Texas. It's what I love to do. It's what I love to share. And I love others to come along with me that want to collaborate and bring more of that abundance and joy to the world. And I just want to keep sharing with you that I believe it's possible to do this in the world. Okay, I got to go. I'm going to visit my dad. Thanks for watching. He's calling me right now. And I'd love to hear your comments below. And I would love for you to come see me at a show, stringsinthewoods.com. Or if you want to join our list, please join our email list, join.stringsinthewoods.com. You're going to get updates about what I'm doing there, shows, events, things like that. Join.stringsinthewoods.com. Please, Amy, please, Cindy, Papadillo, please subscribe. Join at join.stringsinthewoods.com.